Well, the coronavirus has now reached the Pacific Islands. Fiji has confirmed its first case of the virus. And on Wednesday night, the Samoan government said an Aucklander was being held in quarantine with their test results due back in about a week. So to tell us more about these cases and why COVID-19 poses a particular threat to members of the Pacifica community, both in the Pacific Islands and, of course, here in New Zealand, we're joined by our fabulous Pacific correspondent, Barbara Dreaver.
Nice
first
to be
of all, can you give us a bit of an update? I mean, where are things at with those cases in the Pacific now?
OK, so the case in Samoa, which is of particular relevance to our Auckland Pacifica community, we'll get the results of that maybe tomorrow or the next day. It's been sped up. But it could likely be a negative, so we mustn't panic until we get that. And also the case in Fiji, OK, we know that's a positive. That's quite grim. That was a flight attendant. So the whole of Lautoka is in lockdown. Nobody can get in or out. We've got the government is buying food to take in, and that's things like agricultural products, and no more meetings of 20 plus. So they've acted really quickly. They've set up fever clinics. Now, why is this important? Well, good question. Of course, Pacifica quite vulnerable in terms of diabetes, nearly three times more likely to have diabetes here in New Zealand. So you can imagine, Joy, if this sweeps through our communities here. We are vulnerable. Pacifica like to kiss, hug. There's big, we're a community. So we work in communities, churches, all that all needs to stop. People need to stop. God will listen to you if you pray at home. Like, seriously, do not go to church.
On that note, then, what are the implications then if that case in Samoa, we don't want to overhype it, if it perhaps does turn out to be positive? Like, what does that mean for those who want to go home, they want to see their parents? Will the flights still keep going in some capacity?
Well, look, no Pacifica can come to New Zealand unless they're a citizen or resident. So, no. But if they're saying on humanitarian grounds, so I guess what the government, and they've done everything right in terms of protecting our Pacific neighbours. I want to emphasise that cutting the borders is the right thing to do. If there's someone gets sick overseas, I'm thinking they may think of bringing them here. They're talking about humanitarian reasons. So maybe. But at the moment, no, nobody can come in or out unless you're a citizen or a resident.
Can I just ask and put things in perspective for us? Obviously, we're very lucky in New Zealand. We have a very developed health system. What's it like over there? If coronavirus hits the town?
Fiji is the best place if you're going to have COVID-19. Fiji is the best place because they're very strict there, so I guess the sort of authoritarian government may actually work in this case. They're putting very strict measures in place. They've got testing there. They've got fever clinics set up. They've got hospitals. No, I mean, it's not New Zealand, it's not Australia, but they do have good measures.
Samoa, though, with that measles outbreak, I mean,
Tonga, Samoa, oh my gosh, my heart just sinks, you know, having had to go through the measles epidemic. This can't happen. It cannot get to Samoa. The government there, to be fair, have been acting right from the beginning. They've been the most proactive government almost in the world in stopping people going to Samoa, and that is because they have seen death straight up front, and they do not want it again for their people. And, you know, they have not sat idly by, or it'll be right, mate. They have acted, and that is the right thing to do. They've been COVID-19 free, but we have this one case which we are still waiting to hear, and that is why New Zealand has cut off its borders to Pacific Islanders to stop anyone here going there.
Yeah, I guess we have to, though. That's our responsibility there. Our neighbours, that is the backyard of New Zealand. But, Barbara, thank you so much for joining us. You can see how passionate you are, how emotional you are
about worried. This. I'm worried for our people. I'm worried for my community. They're vulnerable. Act now. Do not stop. Do not wait. Just act now.
Pretty serious public messaging there, and I think it's something we do need to take. I mean, you are an incredible service to that community, Barb.
Oh, it works both ways,
I love how much of a damn you give, and I can see how much this is, how important this is to you, Barb. So I just, you know, this is, I mean, this, as a Wellingtonian who lives in Auckland, the jewel in the crown of the city is the Pacifica community.
Absolutely, John.
But there are cultural mores in the Pacifica community which are about being close to each other and community. I'm envious of them. The heart. It's the but at the moment we have to set them aside, right?
Totally.
Particularly in physical senses.
Yes.
And so, as tough as that is, it's a very important message. And I just want to say, listen to Barbara Dreaver.
And hope and pray.
And the experts, right?
Yeah.
Listen to the experts.
Yeah.
Listen to the experts.